Let's do this one now. Find f w prime of pi over 4. F of x is secant x. So here, f of x is secant x. I need to find f prime of x. Then I need to find f double prime of x. Then I need to find f double prime of pi over 4. I need to find f double prime of pi over 4. So I need to find f prime of x, then f double prime of x, then f double prime of pi over 4. Let's find now f prime of x. If we have that secant, or if you know that secant, what is the derivation of c f prime? Oh, yeah, and what's the derivation of secant?
Secant tan.
Thank you.
Secant tan.
So I have secant x tan x. Then I need to find now f double prime of x. Here they are. We have to use the product rule. This is f and this is g. We will say that if f is secant x, so f prime is secant tan. And if g is tan, so g prime, it will be secant squared. Then the power rule is f prime g plus g prime f. So where's f prime? It is secant tan.
Secant tan is 10.
Secant tan. This is an f prime times g, which is tan, plus g prime, which is secant square, times f, which is secant x. Is it clear here? So I have now f double prime is secant tan tan plus secant cubic x. Now, by now, until now, is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. So then secant times secant is tan squared. Tan times tan is tan squared. And secant times secant is secant cubic.
Cubic.
And it was, where's tan? You mean secant?
La, tan cubic. It was tan squared and tan.
No, it was secant, tan, tan. Then I will go back. That's what. Tan times tan is tan squared. And secant squared times secant is secant cubic. So, but here I will have, so I will write here too, and I will delete the second one. And here I will delete this one, and I will write cubic. Okay?
Okay.
So f double prime here is secant tan squared plus secant cubic x. Now f double prime, but now not for x, for pi over 4. So I have to evaluate now instead of x with pi over 4. So I will say it is secant pi over 4 times tan squared of pi over 4 plus secant cubic of pi over 4. I just evaluate x, or sorry, pi over 4 instead of x. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yes, teacher.
Then I use now, or I need now to find the answer. Now, secant pi over 4. All of us know that the secant is 1 over cosine. So, secant pi over 4 is 1 over cosine pi over 4. And cosine pi over 4 is 1 over square root of 2. Okay, so the secant of pi over 4, I told you it is 1 over 1 over square root of 2. So the secant pi over 4, it will be? What?
One over one square root of 4.
We know from algebra that secant x is 1 over cosine x. I need to find now secant pi over 4. And why I use this formula? Because in calculator here, there's no secant. We have only sine, cosine, and tan. There's no secant. So what we have to do? We know that secant is 1 over cosine. So, and secant pi over 4, if I have to use the secant pi over 4, I will say it's 1 over cosine pi over 4. Then, cosine pi over 4 is 1 over square root of 2. So 1 divided by 1 over square root of 2, it will be the secant of pi over 4. So what's the answer? If you divide 1 by 1 over square root of 2?
Square root of 2.
Square root of 2, thank you. So secant pi over 4 is square root of 2. So secant pi over 4 now, I wrote instead of it, square root of 2. So square root of 2 times tan il pi over 4. Tan il pi over 4 is 1. So I will say 1 squared plus secant cubic of pi over 4. Now the secant of pi over 4 is square root of 2 cubic. Secant pi over 4 is square root of 2. So secant cubic of pi over 4 will be square root of 2 cubic. Then square root of 2 plus square root of 2 cubic. What does it mean? That means square root of 2 times square root of 2 times square root of 2. Then square root of 2 multiplied by square root of 2 is 2. So I will say it is 2 square root of 2. Is it right?
Yes.
Then square root of 2 plus 2 square root of 2. It will be?
3 square root of 2.
3 square root of 2. Thank you. This will be the answer now. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Another example. If y is tan x plus third tan cubic x, find dy over dx if x is zero. Tan x plus third tan cubic x, if x is equal to zero, find dy over dx when x is zero. So the first step here, what we have to do? Find dy over dx. Tan x, what is the derivation of tan?
Secant square
x plus, here we have cubic. This is for the chain rule type. Okay, let's make it this one, wrote as sine. So plus third, what's the derivation of sine? Cosine.
Cosine.
Dy over dx is secant squared x plus third cosine x. I want now to find dy over dx when x equals zero. The question he asked me now to find it when x is equal to zero. We'll say dy over dx when x equals 0 is secant square of 0 plus third cosine 0. Now, as you know, cosine 0 is 1 and secant 0 is 1 over cosine 0, which is also 1. So the cosine here is 1 and the secant here is 1. So I will say secant of 0 is 1. Squared, it is 1. Plus 1 over 3 times 1. So it will be 1 plus 1 over 3. Which it will be 4 over 3. This will be the answer. Is it clear?
Yes,
teacher. Do you have any question? Yes, do you have any question here?
No, thank you.
So we have to find if a prime, then evaluate it with the given angle. And as we know, the secant is 1 over cosine, and the cosecant is 1 over sine. Tan is sine over cosine, and the cotan is cosine over sine. This is what we talked about last semester. Is everything clear now?
Yes, teacher.
Yes.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Thank you for listening. Have a nice time.